Welcome all back to Red Dead Redemption. Now we're gonna go help this Marshal Sheriff man. We'll deal with you question mark later. Justice in Pike's Basin. Pike's Basin. Oh god, we're gonna shoot people.
Hello, it's Armadillo 731. What is it with these things? Hello, it's a new line. Hello, hello.
Sounds fun. What's happening?
I have no idea. If it's important, they'll send someone down like they did with you.
Suddenly, the world is full of theys.
Yeah. I remember when we first got here. We used to consider people from Dade County to be exotic. Now guys can get here from the Midwest, and they can do it in 6 days.
Things have changed.
They've gotten away from me. Hello? I don't understand it no more, boy. Honest goodness.
I'm not sure I do.
Marshal! 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 I've just been up in the canyon, spying like you said. I think I seen me a couple of them rustlers. I think it was the Baller twins and a couple of Mexicans.
They up there right now?
Well, it was a group of four men rounding up Mr. Gulch's livestock, and none of them looked like any of Gulch's hands, so yes, sir, right now.
That sarcasm's most unbecoming, Eli. It's gonna hold you back in life, even worse than your lazy eye. All right, let's go. You ride with us again, Marston?
Will you help me?
I will try.
And it'd be my pleasure.
God damn it, Eli, and your sarcasm. This isn't my horse, is it?
No messing around, Marston!
This is my horse.
How right. Long you been working for the government, Marston?
I don't work for the government.
Well, I got a telegram from some federal clowns in Blackwater that says otherwise.
Are you some kind of vigilante?
You don't look like no government, boy.
I guess it's complicated. I came because it was made impossible for me not to.
You sure are a tight-lipped son of a bitch, mister.
I guess I am. I ain't gonna dig this hole no deeper.
Ain't you all proud and superior? Don't forget you need us more than we need you. Bill Williamson folded you up like an empty person last time, if I remember correctly.
Simmer down, Jonah.
Listen to your boss, Jonah. There's a good boy. Otherwise, I'll put a hole in your hillbilly head and watch your tiny brain drain out.
Shut up, Jonah. You win your...
I'll be honest with you, Marston.
I won't say much
ain't for
about
all
Jonah.
This government interference.
Believe me, Marshal, neither am I.
I try to keep the federal boys happy. I mean, we need all the help we can get. But what does a flannel-mouthed city boy who's never forked a bale of hay in his life know about a state like New Austin?
Nothing, I reckon.
All this manifest destiny hogwash came in a wild land. Nearly there.
Good. Wow, that... Is it just me or is it looking really blurry? Like a depth of view just smudged over it. Someone smudged Vaseline over my TV.
Right. Leave the horses here and follow me.
That's my expensive
horse.
Let's
move up the canyon towards the fort.
Well, after you.
Be ready, boys. We're probably going to be outnumbered.
And those bastards ain't short on firepower, neither.
Let's see how many there are. If we can take them alive, good. If not, smoke the sons of bitches.
You know what, Eli? You're pretty cool.
Marshal.
Put up. Come on. I miss having like a Wild West film to watch. Then again, Wild West games aren't even that like common anyway.
Are you gonna shoot any of these rustlers, boy?
I shot them.
You boys take the left fork. I'm going this way. Marston, you can tag along with me or join the deputies.
What the heck?
I'll join you, Sheriff.
Stop falling behind!
Over there!
We gotta push forward!
Loot body.
I doubt you'll be needing this.
This is bad!
Alright. I forgot, Rockstar game. If the Marshal dies, that's it. Oh, ow.
There's two behind that rock.
I ain't never lost no fight. Look out over there. I see something.
I see one of them. Put down your guns and surrender.
Come on, fairy chicken.
Follow me.
What's the matter? Ain't got the sand for a real fight?
Jesus, well.
Hey, buddy.
Yet.
Oh, stay with me.
You really want to die?
Ooh, that looks hot.
There's our boys on the other side.
Look at the deputies. I'll give you this, Marshal. Your deputies are doing well. Hey, a Wilhelm scream. That's good.
Don't try to be something you're not!
Head for that camp. Blast him, boy! Come on! Let's get these sons of bitches!
Loot bodies for ammo and money.
Come on! Stop lagging behind!
Oh, shut up. Who's speaking? That you, Jonah? Of course, it's a nice shot.
Like that's all the sons of bitches. I'll head up the ridge to scout it out. See if there's any spare ammo in that camp.
Righty-ho. You the boss.
What can I say, partner?
I made enough to pay back Bonnie her $15. Maybe I should go back to Bonnie after this. Also, the stagecoach costs money. Like a taxi in GTA, any GTA really. Okay, that's it. Is there a chest? There is a chest. Open it. Hell yes. What did I get? Just got money? Yep, $5. Oh boy, $5. Oh, another chest.
Let's go, Marston. We gotta keep moving.
Hey, you told me to loot this place. Ammo. Alright. And money. Oh boy, $11.
Yeah. Watch out. Looks like there's a couple of snipers over there.
Snipers?
Eyes up! Sniper! I'm giving you one last chance to put your hands in the air! There's one more for the vultures.
I don't know where he is.
This way! There's the bastard.
Sheriff, where is he?
Nice and steady now. Don't leave yourself open. Come on, Marston. I can't take them all by myself.
I've been doing all the work, Sheriff.
Let's get to the rest of the boys.
Ow. Sheriff, no, that's a kill zone. Oh my god. Sheriff, why would you cross the bridge, you idiot? Oh my god. There are like people shooting at the bridge.
They're them snipers. My god.
I got it. Snipers I can deal with.
Shooting, boy.
I'm gonna shoot you dead.
There's one of them.
Look out!
You better surrender! You hear? Let's push on. It sounds like the deputies could use a hand. Over there.
How is the Marshal not getting shot? Wow, Eli just glitched out.
This looks as good a spot as any. Gather around and listen up. All right, stealthy as you can, boys. Let's get as close to those bastards as we can.
How do I crouch down? Oh, there we go. L3's crouch. Hey man, I got this one. Imagine if this wasn't a bad guy. That guy's gonna see me, isn't he?
Get no
but.
Hellfire! There's innocents down there.
Nope. Well. Oh my god, who's shooting?
I'm the goddamn law.
Deputies.
Where's your brand and iron now? Are you kidding me? You got him good.
We're done for.
I did. Nope, 100% me.
Good shot!
Damn, Shatterfoot!
Thanks, Marshal. We're indebted to you with our lives.
Just get them cattle back safe.
All right.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
Well done, Mr. Marston.
Yes, well done.
Now, about Williamson.
I'll do what I can. You know, as you can see, this country is infested with all manner of scum.
Say that again.
Well, one other thing, Marston. Mr. Johnson, sir. It's Mr. Wes Dickens. He's missing.
Who?
Mr. Wes Dickens, the tonics merchant. He was due in town last week.
Oh, the narcotic and bat piss salesman. Con's housewives out of their money with promises of eternal youth.
Yes, him, but I think you're being a little unfair. He's helped a great many of the county, and many of the townsfolk are really missing him.
You hear that, Marston? We just butchered a gang of thieves, and the town is up in arms about a missing snake oil merchant. I am so glad to be serving such a wise and respectable people. Come on, Eli.
Yes, you go on ahead with your frame rate killing cows. And bunch of people. Well, whereas I have to remain here. I guess it's good though, I get to loot their bodies. Nigel West Dickens can be found in Cholla Springs. Nice. I wonder what's the if I get like an ultimate outlaw. Come on. I need to loot him. Loot, come on. Damn it, John. Bunch of TNT lying around. And I keep hiccuping. Loot. Oh, you ain't gonna need these. Are those chests that I can open? Yes. Nice, money. I think we're gonna head back to Bonnie now. Yes, let's just open everything here first. $12? Oh boy. You. Dude, I've got $250. I'm basically a millionaire here. Alright. Let's go loot some of these bodies. But not all of them, because I can't be bothered to do backtrack. Okay. So start. No, not start. Back. Select. Kit. Basic campsite. You cannot set up a camp in town settlement or gang hideout. Well, shit. I am not in... Oh, why? Can I just quick travel from the gang hideout? How far am I from Bonnie? Not that far. Okay. We'll set a waypoint. Come here, horse.
Let's go.
GTA Wild West. I think it might be because I got the Game of the Year edition that I have these special horses and stuff. It's good though. I like my horse. I'm not gonna give him a name though. He's still called Horse. Take a sharp left here. Oh, here I am. That was a quick way back. McFarland's Ranch. Alrighty, where is Bonnie's house? Obviously a nice big one. So they own this entire bit of land? Alright. In a bit horse. Women and cow.
I've been hearing about your plans.
Have you, Miss McFarlane?
Yes, from Lee Johnson. To settle here and build a life for yourself.
I'm afraid those aren't my plans. See, I already have a life. Well, I had one and I'm trying to reclaim it. Or maybe what you could say is I had two and I'm trying to end one of them so the other can survive.
You do so love to talk in riddles, Mr. Marston. Do you do that, I wonder, as a substitute for having anything interesting to say?
Probably, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, call me Bonnie, you fool. Call me Bonnie.
Miss McFarlane, I'm married. I have a son. I had a daughter, but she died. Years before that, I rode in a gang. We robbed banks. Trains, held people ransom. We killed people we didn't like. Bill Williamson was in that gang. Now, if I don't capture my former brother in arms, great harm will befall my family. Now, I don't suppose any of this is very interesting to you, but I hope it explains why I wasn't so eager to talk about it.
No, I do understand. I had no idea. You poor man.
Even in this new country, memories don't really fade. My father was an illiterate Scot born on the boat into New York. He never saw his homeland, but to hear him talk about it, you'd imagine he only ever ate haggis and wore a kilt. And he hated the English for what they had done to his great-grandparents that he'd never met. People don't forget. Nothing gets forgiven.
That's true, especially when it comes to money. And you know, even now, after all his labors, my father's debts are still terrible. I worry every day about us losing the ranch. It would kill him.
My father died when I was 8 years old. His eyes were, well, let's just say he was blinded in a bar fight south of Chicago. My mother died during childbirth. She was a prostitute, and he was her... Well, I don't know what he was. So I was sent off to an orphanage and ran away and fell in with a gang.
My word. What a difficult life you've lived.
The leader of the gang taught me how to read, taught me how to see all that was good in the world. He was a great man, in a way.
But you killed people.
Sure. And I've suffered for it. And that's the life I left, or tried to leave. Ah, said too much, Bonnie. I'm an uneducated killer, sent here to do all I can do well. Kill a man in cold blood so that another man may do his part to cut crime in an area, and a rich man can be elected governor on the back of these promises.
Civilization is a truly beautiful thing, Mr. Marston. Listen, can you help me?
Well, I can try. What do you need, money?
No, nothing so complicated. I need an extra hand to take out the herd to pasture.
Sure. Point me in the right direction.
Right, so we're going together? Herding cows. Sure. I am, after all, a cowboy.
Right. Are you ready to learn how to herd some cows?
Not sure. Am I? All your missions have been really, really tough, Bonnie.
Thank you for telling me all that back there. It must have been hard for you.
I hope you understand now why I've been playing my cards somewhat close to my chest.
I didn't know you had a wife and child. Then again, I don't think I ever asked. They're lucky to have a man like you.
I ain't so sure about that, but thank you.
Are you hitting on me, Bonnie? Because if you are... I don't know what to think. Hey, cows. Move the position behind the herd.
Whoa!
Here we go. Herd the cows out of the pen.
Nice job, Mr. Marston. That's it.
Gotta match the speed. Get behind the cows and run. Hey, 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 cows.
Herd the cows down the road. Pretend you know what you're doing.
Come on, you dumb heifer.
Cows, cows, cows.
Get right at them! Drive them this way!
Cows, go.
You're a rancher now, Marston. Show them who's boss, don't.
Let's go!
Come on, cows, let's go. It would be a lot easier if my horse wasn't so goddamn fast.
He's just showing off now.
Good! Now we need to move this entire herd out to the far pasture for grazing.
That's a lot of cows. Eat your grass. Stupid cows.
The herd. Ranching might be your true calling, Mr. Marston. Either that, or you were a cow in a past life.
Thank you, Miss McFarland.
I'll see you later. I have work to do back at the ranch.
Let's get it.
Oh, am I done? Screw these cows, then. Let's go back to Bonnie. Yeah, honor. There we go. Please don't make me do more farm shit. Alright. Best farm shit ever. 5 PM today. What time is it? It's nearly 5 PM. Let's go to the shop. Let's see what I can buy. It'll help me kill some time. Hey, buddy boy.
Howdy, mister.
Survivalist map. Snake oil. Ammo, ammo, ammo. Infested. So what? Oh, these are horses. War horse. I've already got a horse though. And it's a 3-star horse as well, so I'm good, thank you. What's a survivalist map? Don't need anything that though, do I?
Thank you.
Nice doing business with
gunshots. Why are there gunshots? Let's ignore that for a bit. Wild horses, tame passions. Oh dear. So I assume I'm going to learn about taming horses then.
Hello, Mr. Marston. How are you?
Fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Did you meet my father? John Marston, this is my father, Drew McFarlane.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Marston. Please. So, my daughter informs me that you're here on some secret mission to remove some undesirables from the county.
Something like that. I'm grateful for the hospitality, sir.
Well, you know, we've lived here for 30 years now. Came here from the east. The land had never been settled. For 10 years, we fought the Indians. Tough men. And we had outlaws, and we had drought, and we had smallpox, terrible winters, cholera. I buried more of my children than I raised.
Sorry to hear that, sir.
I've seen strong men wither and die under that unforgiving sun. That whole herd of cattle was take sick and die. But I've never once doubted my life here.
No, sir.
When I hear about this so-called federal government sending out agents to covertly murder and control people, then I start to worry. I mean, yeah, all right, Williamson is a menace, and men like him are the plague. But isn't a government agent a worse menace? And all that symbolizes, I mean.
You may be right, sir.
Well, you're a brave man. You're always going to be welcome here. But you tell your friends out east that we don't want to live like that out here. And sneaking around and spying and secret missions. It's preposterous.
Trust me, sir. I agree with you.
Good. Well, we won't insult you any further. Come on, Bonnie. We got things to do.
Mr. Marston, do you want to join us? It's Daddy's favorite pastime. Apart from political discourse, that is.
What is?
Breaking in horses. Come on. I hear you're a pretty decent rider. For a city dweller, that is.
You're gonna need this, Mr. Marston.
A bit kinky, don't you think?
Let's see if we can put that new lasso of yours to good use. That ranch hand said there's a pack of wild horses nearby.
My horse is easy to find. It's the jet black one. All right, good sir, after you.
You sure have some interesting theories on what the government's doing, sir.
They ain't theories, Mr. Marston. I saw the telegram Marshal got from Blackwater. It ain't exactly a state secret it sent you.
Well, is he wrong? I saw those men from the train.
The government can go to hell if you ask me. Those sons of bitches that steal a coin off a dead man's eyes.
Mr. Marston!
He's right. Now, I don't know much about politics.
Please, Paul, can we just enjoy
the
ride?
But I know we're only as free as they say we are. Power's like a drink. The more you have, the more you want. And there's few men who can handle it.
There's certain things in this country a woman could do much better if you ask me.
I ain't gonna argue with that, Miss McFarland.
No, no ma'am, of course not. You right? Yeah, well... am I gonna chip in on how the government is ruining everything? No, of course not. Look at the herd.
There they are! Let's get after them!
Rope one of them for me, Marston!
L2 to draw your lasso. A to lasso a horse, aim and then press R2.
You gonna use that rope or not?
Calm yourself. I'm picking out a horse.
Hold tight. Coming to help you. He almost had him there.
Easy now.
That's not good. You didn't do very well.
Go.
You're by yourself, right?
Hold on, Marston. Don't lose him. Keep at it, Marston.
Come on.
How are you going to break a wild horse if you can't ride a tame horse?
That's enough!
Hold the lasso horse. I am holding it.
Come on, boy. He's all yours. He's a handsome one, all right. There he is. Do it now, boy.
What do I do? Get off?
Don't let him buck you, Mr. Marston. Lean into
You're
him.
You're doing fine.
Balance. Balance.
Almost got you.
Balance.
Easy.
Balance.
You'll have
balance. Come on. Left.
It,
right. Right.
Keep at it, Mr. Marston.
Come on,
slow
baby.
Now.
You mind. Come on.
Try not to
relax.
Spook him too much.
Show me what you got, boy.
Yeah. Hey.
Don't give up.
Come on. Come on. Nearly got you.
Yeah.
Look at that. We'll make a cowboy out of you yet. Mount up, Marston. You leave this one to me. I think that's enough activity for an old-timer like me. I'll take this one back to the ranch. See you later.
Come on, then. Let's see if you can get another one.
Alrighty.
What are you waiting for? Come on, boys. That's it.
Here we go.
I got you now.
I do.
Relax. Here we go.
Yeah. This is intense,
now.
Actually. He's about to throw
there.
Me off.
Whoa.
Hey.
That's it.
This view is making me kind of sick. Alrighty. Don't lose the horse, Bonnie.
I like your father.
I'm glad. He's quite a character.
You have a good life here. A life I want. For me and my family, I mean.
We don't have a lot anymore.
You have enough. It's one that gets so many folks in trouble.
It'll sap your spirit and make you poor. But it's straight. And it's decent.
There's no better night's sleep than after an honest day's work.
It's no wonder you look so tired then.
Some deck must be shy of Joker, Miss McFarland.
Your horse is running into me.
Who'd have thought you'd be such a natural at busting broncos?
That was fun.
I think you could be a fine rancher one day, if you can bear to stop killing people for a living.
Sure.
Yeah, why not? Horse. This horse is trying to run so bad. Come on.
Well done, Mr. Marston. These are fine horses.
Hey, Bonnie. Amos was saying some horses have been spotted somewhere outside of Armadillo.
Let's go, Mr. Marston. We can really do with those horses.
Oh my gosh, the mission's not over yet.
No rest for the wicked.
Of course.
Let's see if we can track down that other herd of horses.
Is it gonna be some legendary horse? Like.
You never did tell me why you were never married. Aside from the snobbery, that is.
You sure ask a lot.
I'm just surprised, that's all. You must have been quite a catch.
The fact that you're talking in the past says it all.
No, that's not what I mean. You must have had some suitors, that's all I'm saying.
Some, I suppose. Here and there. A ranch in the middle of Hennigan's stead ain't really the place to find a husband. Amos, he's a little. Well, you know, countrified.
Where'd you get your airs and graces, Miss McFarland?
From a couple of cheap governesses Pa hired to save us from being savages. I'd like to talk about more than just cattle and chickens sometimes, that's all. And after my brother left, it was up to me to become the man of the ranch. He'd never admit it, but my pa's a lot frailer than he looks.
You're worth two of any man I know, miss.
I'll try to take that as a compliment.
You should. It is a compliment.
In many ways, my wife is kind of like you, Miss McFarland.
Is that so?
She's always been a woman in a man's world.
You don't talk about her very much. Looks like the ranch hand's up ahead.
Hey, buddies. Right behind them. No, I'm not going right behind you.
Let's drive them up the canyon where it narrows. We'll trap them there.
Oh, you mean behind the herd of horses. Too fast. Spooky. Time to go off-road with my off-road horse. There we go. Oh no.
Come on.
Hey horsies. You wanna go this way? Around. Come on. And I mean around.
Let's go.
Come on. Hey. Hey, hey, hey.
Whoa.
No, you are not going as well. Come on. Save your heart.
Slow up.
Now, how did they manage to make a game that looks this nice? Oh boy. Nope. You guys are not going up there. Around. Come on. Horses, come on. This way. Hey, 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 hey. There we go.
Looks like we got the lot of them. What magnificent animals they are. Hey, the stallion's getting away. Chase him down and bring him.
Oh, shit. I accidentally skipped it. Nope. I'm chasing it down.
Get after him!
Out of way, fools.
Come on!
Don't worry. Don't worry, warhorse. I'm replacing you. Come on, stay. Stop running in a circle, you bloody idiot. There we go.
Come on, baby. Calm down.
This isn't making me feel well.
Easy. You're mine now.
Calm yourself. Come on.
Whoa. Relax now. Almost got you.
There we go. Yo, stop veering. And here we are.
Thanks for your help today, Mr. Marston. We got some fine horses. You know, why don't you keep that stallion as your own, as a thank you from all of us?
Thank you, ma'am. He's a fine animal.
She just fucks off. Good. Horses hurt at 6. Yeah, but I think not. You're good. But you're not our horse good.